gospel. Furthermore, our life declaration should be like that of Christ. That even when I'm tempted to think about what I want, when I want to do what I want to do, Christ says, not my will, but thine be done. Since the formulation of Judeo-Christianity, Christ calls us to not only walk in a walk of self-denial, but calls us to live a life of unconditional sacrifice. For the second century church father, Tertullian, once said, the blood of the martyrs is the seed of the church. So if Tertullian's message is correct, why is this message of unconditional sacrifice no longer preached? Why don't we hear anymore of more William Tyndales? Why don't we hear anymore of more Dietrich Bonhoeffers? Why don't we hear anymore of any more Martin Luther King Jr.'s? We have sought our own wealth. We have sought our own safety. And we have sought our own fortunes. But yet Christ says, if you want to be my disciple, you must first deny yourself. But then he says, you must pick up your cross. And he says in the text, their cross, which implies that there is a cross for you. And there is a cross for me. I cannot bear your cross, and you cannot bear my cross. But we must all bear a cross. For the hymn writer said, must Jesus bear the cross alone? And all the world go for it? No, there's a cross for everyone. And there's a cross for me. The consecrated cross I'll bear till death shall set me free. And then go home my crown to wear. For there's a crown for me. So Lord, if my cross gets me mocked and ridiculed, I'll bear it. Lord, if my cross causes my family and friends to leave, I'll bear it. Lord, if my cross causes me to lose all material wealth and fame, I'll bear it. Lord, if the cross costs me my very life, I'll bear it. Because without a cross, I can't receive my crown. So once a believer has purpose in their heart to live a life of self-denial, once they have purposed that I must walk with unconditional sacrifice, the last thing Christ says is to walk in a life of wholehearted service. The last thing Christ says in this verse is, follow me. We see that Christ does not say follow me first, but last, which implies that although many want to follow Christ, they will never be able to because they have not been conformed to the image of a follower. Many are far too concerned with their own agendas, plans, and proposals. And yet they are too busy trying to lead without being able to follow. And this morning Christ tells us that if we want to follow him authentically, our reply should be like that of Isaiah. That when God was searching for someone to go to his people, Isaiah said, here am I, send me. So if we want to leave Louisville better and more equipped than how we came, our lives must be spent following Jesus. So I can hear Christ saying this morning, follow me when you're all alone with no support like Abraham. Follow me when all you have is dreams like Joseph. Follow me when you're second guessed like David. Follow me when you're second guessed like Daniel. Follow me when you've messed up like Jonah. Follow me when you're stoned like Stephen. Follow me when you're exiled like John. Follow me when you're crucified like Peter. Follow me when you're beheaded like Paul. Follow me as I cure AIDS in Africa. Follow me as I feed the hungry in Asia. Follow me as I eradicate poverty in South America. Follow me as I bring peace in Iraq. Follow me as I teach the ignorant across the world. Follow me as I save sinners follow me until you reach that city that sits on 12 foundations.